Where you go, I'll go. Where you stay, I'll stay. When you move, I'll move. I will follow.
So we've come to the end of our first core practice. First core practice is repent and be baptized. So this is session five. We're going to do five sessions with each core practice. And really, everything we've been doing this week is culminating at this point. So this is a very, very important lesson. So we're going to look back at Matthew chapter 4, 17 to 20. And that's how we started in verse 4, 17. From that time on, Jesus began to preach, "Repent, for the kingdom of heaven has come near." And as Jesus was walking beside the Sea of Galilee, he saw two brothers, and they were fishermen. "Come follow me," Jesus said, "and I will send you out to fish for people." At once they left their nets and followed him. So I just want to recap a few things and then get to the takeaway for us today. I want to just remind you of the word repent. And the idea of repentance is metanoia, to change our thinking, but it's always implied that more than our thinking will change, actually our lifestyle will change, our behaviors will change. And I also want you to see that he is calling these, this is known as calling of his first disciples, and we're using the word apprentice. That's the idea of a disciple. It's not just saying, "I believe in Jesus." It's not just saying, "I want to be a learner." But it's saying, "I am someone who is going to be apprenticed by Jesus. Someday I'm going to do the things that Jesus did." I'm not saying that we're going to become the Son of God, but there are things we will learn to do, behaviors and ministry skills Jesus will have trained us in. And then we will train others to do that. And you notice that whole apprentice model where Jesus calls these first people. It's going to be Simon Peter and his brother Andrew. And he says to them, "Come follow me." That's apprentice recruiting language. "Come follow me, learn from me." But then he says, "And I will send you out to fish for people." Some translations say that, "And I will make you fishers of men," or fishers of people. And so here's the whole idea of being an apprentice. We got to turn away. We got to repent from where we were. And there's a big moment where we have to do that. And then there's smaller moments all throughout our journey. And we repent, we turn away from that, we have a new king, a new master, and it is Jesus. And Jesus says to us, follow him, learn from him, but then also so that we can pass this on to others, to fish for people, to draw others into this apprenticeship lifestyle. And so I want you today, the read and react portion of our day, is for you to just review what you've learned this week. Review the different passages, and now put together something to the effect of, what does this look like in your life this week? Not what's this going to look like in 3 years, or what did this look like 3 years ago, but what are you going to do with this? What is a practical expression of repenting and being baptized? If you've never been baptized, there's a clear application of this. Right? You need to talk to someone about taking that step. But if you have been baptized, what might it look like for you? What will I do in response to Jesus clearly calling me to a life of repentance and being baptized in him, being fully associated and identified with him? I hope you'll write that down. I hope you'll communicate it to someone. This is what I'm going to do. This is how I'm going to put into practice this first core practice. Lord Jesus, I pray over these apprentices. I pray for myself. Jesus, would you show us what it means to repent and be baptized, what that should look like in my life this week. Amen. Where you go?